2 megabytes, 1.4 megabytes, 2.5 megabytes. That's already a lot of unnecessary megabytes. That's unacceptable. Except it's not. But it is a good practice to use smaller size images to help your website load faster. WebP enables high quality image display on websites with significantly smaller file sizes than JPEG and PNG. In Webflow, you can convert your images, that's JPG, JPEG and PNG, to WebP super quickly. We'll do this in three parts. First, we'll convert images in our assets panel. We'll then do the same thing in our CMS collections, but in one simple step. And finally, we'll republish our site to make sure our converted images are live in production. Step one, we're here in the designer and we'll make our way to the assets panel. I can go in and expand the panel. Here, I'll select the image I want. I'll do this one, and why not? I'll select this one too. You can select multiple images. And if we take a look at their file information, we can see that they're quite large. With both of them selected, I'll go up and click Compress. Before we continue to actually confirm the conversion, it's good to know that Webflow will automatically create a site backup for you. So if needed, you can bring back those original JPG, JPEG, and PNG. Let's click Compress. Webflow will now work on compressing the images and will get notified once it's completed. Depending on how many assets you're converting, time will vary. And just as a note, all instances of these assets throughout the site will be updated with a compressed version. But once it's done, let's go back to our assets panel, click into one of our converted images, our WebP file, and if we pull up a side-by-side here, we can see that our current image is now a WebP file and is significantly smaller. That's compressing and converting in the assets panel. Let's move on to step two, converting all our CMS images in our CMS collections. Similar approach here. We'll navigate to our CMS collection panel. And here we have a few collections. And in these collections, we have a bunch of images that we want to convert. We have some in image fields, others in multi-image fields, and even images in rich text fields. We want all of those images to be converted to WebP for a smaller file size and better site performance. And we want to do it all at once. Now, if we go up here in our CMS collection tab, we'll find these three tiny dots and we'll compress all assets. Same thing as earlier, Webflow lets you know that a site backup will be created because once you convert your images, you cannot change it back other than by restoring a site backup. Let's go ahead and click Compress. Webflow will now work on compressing the images and will get notified once it's completed. Depending on how many assets you're converting, time will vary. And you might be thinking, that sounds very familiar. But that's compressing all your images in our CMS collections. Let's move on to the final step, republish. Now that we compressed all the assets we wanted to WebP, we need to republish because our live site currently doesn't have the WebP images we just converted. We'll go up and press publish and we'll publish our site. Now, our live site is published and is using those WebP images. Now, we have more info about why and when we should use WebP over on Webflow University. So check out that documentation if you haven't already. That's converting your images to WebP in the Webflow Designer.